Hi there, you guys. This is Cindy. I was just going to offer you some nice breathing exercises just to relax your body, little stretches just to kind of release any tension you might be having during this time. So I thought I would bring myself to Cherokee Park, Beargrass Creek. Very nice scenery here. Early morning, so hopefully I won't be disturbed. People won't think I'm strange out here. You can hear a little bit of the trickling, I think, of the water. It's really nice. So we'll just start beginning with our breathing. This portion is just kind of breath work and upper body work. It's easier probably to do it in a chair, but I wasn't going to haul a chair out here, and I just thought it would be nice scenery for some breath work. So we're just going to start off with that. So bring yourself to a nice neutral position in your spine, meaning you're not collapsed, you're not too straight up, but just somewhere where you feel some length in the spine. And just start to feel your sits bones kind of root down a little bit mindfully and just lift up, just creating a little bit of length. Allow your shoulders to rest down, draw your chin in, and then take your gaze down or close your eyes. And we're just gonna start to check in with our breathing. So if you can, breathe in and out the nose. And as you breathe in the nose, see if you can feel the air move through the nose into the lungs. And then can you follow that air back out? So just stay here a few moments, trying to focus on the breath and just notice how it feels. So if you're not used to breath work, maybe just focus on your inhale and notice if that feels smooth, light, or does it feel heavy? Same with the exhale. Does it feel smooth or choppy? Just bring an adjective maybe if you can. I'm not forcing anything, just checking in with our breathing. Can you feel the ribs expand out to the sides, the bottom ribs, the top ribs maybe lift up? With those movements of the ribs, can you feel your shoulders maybe move with the ribs? It's gliding on the back of the shoulders, or the back of the ribs. Maybe feeling the collarbones move up and down. Maybe you feel a little movement with the head on top of the spine. A few more moments here, maybe calming or slowing down the exhalation just to calm the body a little more. Keeping the mind focused, try not to wander. Just kind of notice if anything's changed, if you feel a little bit more relaxed just through through slowing down and focusing on your breath. And then we usually carry tension in our shoulders and in our neck. So we're just going to kind of check in with those areas. So only moving through range of motion that causes no discomfort in your body. Just gently draw your shoulders up towards your ears and just see how that feels, like you're giving your neck a big hug. And then release them down to your back. Draw them down towards your pelvis. A few more times with that, noticing if one side's a little different than the other. One more time. And then just start to maybe do some shoulder rolls. So gently roll them through, forward and back. Slowing our bodies down, slowing the breath down, and really coming in to what feels good in your body. And then reverse it in the other direction. And if it doesn't feel, it feels grindy, then just go in a very smaller range. Or move in a range where it feels good to you. I'm just here to kind of help guide you through some motions that might feel good to your body. And then we're going to gently alternate it. Personally like alternating better, but notice this, how your shoulder blades move on your back, how they move your ribs. Are you tight anywhere? Can you feel that in your lower back? Kind of like you're doing backstroke. And then we're going to reverse it. So roll forward. Can you feel your shoulder blade move off of your spine as you lift up? And feel it like kind of move towards your ribs, towards the side of your ribs. To me, this is this feels better because I have a little tightness in my right side of my back right there, which is actually your left side. And then bring it back to neutral. See if you can sit up just a little bit taller, just getting a little bit more insight to how you feel. Take a few breaths here. Take a moment to pause and notice. Just going to start to move the spine with the breath. So when you're breathing, you only breathe what feels, you know, how it feels good to you. But I'm going to cue breathing. And when you're breathing, if you could have noticed, like when you inhaled, everything kind of expanded. And then when you exhale, things just gently released. So releasing, maybe releasing tension, and then inhaling maybe a little deeper. Maybe you notice a little bit more movement in exhaling. So we're just going to start to move with the breath here. We're going to begin with just arm movement, and just notice how it moves your spine. So we'll release our arms to our side, and then gently inhale, reach your arms up. So nice slow breath. Can you feel your shoulder blades kind of wing out on your spine, like wings extending your spine? Exhale, release down. Two more. Inhale, reach it up. You feel those shoulder blades kind of wing out. Exhale down. Does it feel okay in your shoulders? Is this range of motion good for both shoulders, or is one tighter? And if you're up here, kind of squeeze them up to your ears. Like you're reaching for something, and exhale, release them down. Add your wrists. Kind of get some work there. And then we're going to gently bring them out in front. Inhale, reach up. This, they kind of tuck under your ribs, opening, extending the body. Maybe the head is added. You look up, exhale down. Does it feel better to have the palms rotated towards each other? Working a little bit more lats if you can do that. Exhale, release down. Or does it feel better to have your hands maybe this way? Inhale up. You're going into gentle back bend. Exhale down. So we are kind of extending our spine and moving our ribs out. If you feel like that doesn't feel good, then keep the ribs pulled in and kind of keep your core engaged. So inhale, we're going to move our arms in this direction. Open up, little chest opener here. Maybe looking up, a little bit more of a back bend. Again, pull the ribs in if you're feeling like you need support in your lower back. And then exhale, round, tuck the tailbone under, bring your shoulder blades to hug the sides of your ribs, tuck your chin in. Inhale, open. drawing the oxygen in, exhale round, tucking that chin in. And then gently release your hands to your side. So that was just a nice movement in the spine. We went to flexion, extension. We're gonna do some side bends here. So let's just start with the top of our spine. And we'll bring our right ear down to our right neck, our right shoulder. So we're starting with the neck. And so just notice how that left side feels. And then gently, we're gonna start to add a side bend. So we'll bring our hand back, or our right hand down to our right hip. Relax your right shoulder. Sometimes when we side bend, we lift it up, but just relax it down and then just start to side bend as far as you can over to the right. Keeping that left hip anchored down and just see how that feels between the ribs and the hips. Usually when we side bend, we fold forward. See how it feels in the spine and the shoulder to maybe open up a little bit. We're gonna kind of keep adding a little bit more motion to this. So let's bring our arm out to the side. See if you can notice the force on your back as you reach your left arm up. Does that feel good? And then if it goes all the way up, maybe lift a little bit more. That shoulder blade helps lift your spine away from your hips, but relax the shoulders down. And then maybe gently bend that elbow, bring your hand behind your head and let your head rest back. And notice it might lift up a little bit. Going a little further, taking that right elbow, I'm sorry, left elbow, and opening, gently rotating away from that flexion. See how that feels? So extending our backs more with a little side bend, and then gently, maybe reaching your left arm up and over to the right. Take a few breaths here, notice your breathing. Relax that right shoulder down. And then inhale, and as you exhale, reach up. Use these muscles to pull the ribs back into the hip. And just release down. Take a moment here just to notice how that feels. Noticing the breath. And then we'll take it over to the left side. So gently left ear to left shoulder. Check in with that right side. Notice if you want a side bend. Left hand to the left hip. Start to go a little further, but take your time. Kind of slow down. Notice how the side bend feels on that right side. You stretch it out. Keep the hip anchored down. And then maybe add your left arm if you want. Only go through the range that feels good for you, or not everything I'm showing you is going to feel just perfect for you. So stop or go back to something that did. So reach your left arm, I'm sorry, right arm up as high as you can. Can you feel that stretch from the ribs to the hips? And then gently maybe place the hand behind your head. Relax your head into your hand. Maybe going further and drawing your right elbow back. Feel the rotation in the ribs, the opening. Does that feel good for you? Maybe adding that right arm, extending a little bit more, side bending a little deeper. Relaxing your left shoulder down. Using your right, these muscles on the right side, pull your right ribs into your right hip and release out of that. Notice how that feels. Take a moment here. Maybe become in tune to the ribs, the movement of the ribs. And then we're gonna gently go into a little bit of a rotation. So create some length here in the spine on your inhale, just being aware of that inhale. And then on your exhale, we'll rotate to the right. So bring your right hand behind you, like a kickstand, but don't sink into your rotator cuff. think of drawing that right shoulder blade into your spine. Bring your left hand over to your right knee. And on your exhale, take a nice twist, nice rotation. Maybe your gaze goes all the way over that right shoulder. Gently bring it back. Take a moment, a breath in and out. So we are slowing down. So take your time, focus, and notice how that feels. So twists are really good for the abdominal cavity because they kind of wring it out, so they create movement in those organs. It's also good for your spine, kind of moving that synovial fluid around. So inhale, lengthen, and then exhale, twist to the left, and notice. Can you feel a little gentle squeeze in the belly? Feel your, maybe a stretch into the lower back. Twists are good for lower back. Looking over your left shoulder, notice if one side's tighter than the other. Just these nice slow movements are good for the body. Kind of take some side bends, notice how that feels. And we're gonna take one more extension breath here. So bring your hands to your knees. And inhale, start to lengthen through the spine. Lift the chest up. Maybe lift the head up. Tilt your tailbone back. Really think of extending your spine. Tailbone under, pull the belly in, bring your chin to your chest. And again, inhale, lifting up, lengthening. Maybe looking up if that feels good, stretching the throat. Tailbone under, pulling the belly in, and releasing the ribs, the chin down. And one more. Inhale, lengthening, tilting the tailbone back, lifting the chest bone up, the chin up. And then exhale, tucking the tailbone under, pulling the belly in, and releasing all the way down. And then gently bringing your spine back to neutral. What we're gonna do is kind of stay with that extension and do a little bit of neck stretches. So inhale gently, tilt your tailbone back, lift your chest up, and look up, stay with that extension. So the chest is gonna stay lifted, and then you're gonna gently bring your head back to center, tuck the chin in, and then draw the chin down towards the chest bone. Feel a nice stretch in the back of the neck there. Do that one more time. So inhale, keep the chest lifted, lift the chin up, stretch through the throat if that feels good, relax the shoulders down, notice where you feel that, and then keeping the ribs lifted, the chest lifted, exhale, bring the head back to center, chin tucks in so the back of the neck stays long, draw it down to the chest bone. We're gonna stay here for about 3 breaths. So we're gonna start to continue to round. So we're gonna keep our chin down, and then we're gonna allow our chest to kind of curl down, pull the belly in, start to tuck the tailbone in, and then gently kind of lean back into it. So your hands hold onto your knees for a little leverage. And then your shoulder blades are kind of hugging your rib cage now in a flexion. And stay here for a few breaths. Really breathe into the back of those ribs. And then we'll gently bring our pelvis back to neutral, our spine, lift our ribs, take a deep breath in. And exhale, we're gonna bring our right ear back to our right shoulder. But this time, extend your left arm out, kind of like a diagonal line from the crown of the head to the palm of the hand there. And just see how much of a stretch you can get. Think of extending the wrist and maybe spreading the fingers wide. Just taking a few breaths here. And then we're going to gently rotate that left palm to the back. Feel that internal rotation in your shoulder. See how that feels? Does that feel okay? And then gently bend your elbow and slide your hand across that lower back. And take your nose and chin down towards your right shoulder. Think of more lifting in that back occipital lobe there, lifting it up so that you're lengthening more so than dropping down. Notice where you feel that. Does that feel okay in your left shoulder? And then you're gonna rotate your nose and chin back towards the front. Keeping the chin in, start to rotate up a little bit over your left shoulder. So a lot of times we let our chin jut out like that. You don't want to do that. You want to keep the chin tucked in, lengthening the back of the neck there. Gently bring your right ear back to your right shoulder. Oh, try not to side bend. I just realized I was side bending. Try to keep your shoulders right over your hips. So you're just kind of doing some neck stretches there. And then release that. Take a moment. Notice breathing in and out. Staying here for your well-being. Nice and slow. It's good to slow down. These small movements really can do a lot for your body. And then we'll gently take our left ear to our left shoulder. Breathe in and out. Try to keep the shoulder stacked over the hips. Oh, extend the right arm out. And maybe take the stretch all the way through the shoulder plexus there. Try to extend the wrist, really get a stretch maybe through your wrists, your fingers. Strengthen those wrists. Balancing on your wrist and your hands and your shoulders, it's really good for your core. So strengthen those wrists so you can do that. And then rotate the palm back. So internal rotation, how does it feel on that right side? Gently bend the elbow, let it rest, that right hand rest on your lower back, keeping our chin in. Tuck the chin and nose down towards your left shoulder, lengthening the back of the neck. And keeping that chin tucked in, slowly move through. Facing forward, chin and nose facing forward, and then up. So it's like a little bit of an angle. Keeping the chin in, don't let that happen. Keeping your shoulders over your hips so you're just getting that stretch in the neck. Range of motion just in the neck. Now our whole spine works together, but we are just kind of isolating the neck right now, the cervical spine. So see how that feels? That might be too much. And then we're gently going to bring our left ear back down to our left shoulder and then release that. And just take a moment here to notice how the neck feels, the shoulders feel, the whole body. And then we'll just kind of, a lot of times when you do those neck stretches, shoulder stretches, it's a lot for the lower back. So we're just going to kind of release it. So just tuck the tailbone under, pull the belly in, chin down. And we're going to end with a little bit more breath work. And you play around with this. Like if you want to move side to side, notice how your spine moves. We're going to just end here. So just bring yourself back into a seated position. Let your arms relax where they can. Actually, let's do a little bit of a belly breath. So take your hand on your belly, and as you usually they say, your non-dominant hand, just so you're not pressing. And it's just to have a point of force to push into. So as you breathe in through your nose, see if you can actually press your belly gently towards your hand. And this is supposed to be very relaxing breath work. So if it starts to stress you out or you start to feel heavy with the breath, then just go back to a nice relaxed breath. When you exhale, see if you can draw the belly away from the hand. And gently inhale. What's happening here is you're creating a little more space in your abdominal cavity so that the diaphragm can drop down into it. So one more time, and draw the oxygen into the lungs. So the pressure increases, the volume increases, drawing oxygen in. And then as you exhale, this pressure changes, the volume decreases, and the air moves out. So gently bring your hand back to wherever it's comfortable, and then see if you can just gently focus on the breath, that belly breath, as we end, and start to notice if the breathing changes. So we'll bring that length, that awareness to your spine. Draw the chin in. Just check back in one more time with just some normal breath. Notice if the shoulders have released any tension, if the ribs. And then we'll slowly close our eyes and see if you can bring the next few minutes to focus on that belly breath. It's just a nice, deep, relaxing breath. So as you draw the oxygen in through the nose, let the belly gently pull away from the spine, allowing our diaphragm to drop down. Pull that oxygen in, nice, fresh oxygen. And then just gently, no force, allow the belly to release back in, pressing that air back out the lungs. Trying to slow the exhalation down. That dives into our rest and digest nervous system, your parasympathetic nervous system, allowing our bodies to relax, de-stress, allowing our minds to calm down. One more full breath in. Notice if the breathing has changed. The inhalation lighter, more full, and how does the exhale feel? And then gently start to release. Open your eyes, and I hope you guys feel much better. and you should be grateful that you took the time, because I know it's hard to go this slow, to just release tension, just to bring yourself to be aware of how you're breathing and how your body feels. So thanks for joining me. Kind of getting bright out here, so I don't know if you can see me, but have a good rest of your day or evening.